Hello, hello, mic test. Whoa, this is amazing. We have net profit of 94.34%, CAGR of close to 30% now. Maximum drawdown is in control, and profit factor is also amazing. So you can see how we improved the EMA and Doji strategy significantly using the three-layered backtesting approach at Tradomate.one. Hello, financial programmers. I'm Ritvik Dashura, and I'm back with a new video and some new learnings. If you're looking for some great trading strategies, guys, you are at the right place. In this video, I will use Tradomate.one platform to build an amazing trading strategy using EMA and Doji pattern. Just a quick disclaimer, guys. Neither me nor Tradomate.one is giving any recommendation through this video. This is an educational video where I'm teaching you how to build trading strategies using Tradomate.one platform. Please do your detailed research before trading in the live market. Cool, guys. If you're new to my YouTube channel, on this channel, I turn all my viewers to successful financial programmers. Here I upload videos related to making some trading bots, implementation of AI in finance, using some highly valuable finance APIs, making some great trading strategies, etc., etc. So if this is something that you are interested in, then click on the subscribe button and also hit on the bell icon, because there are many more videos that are about to come on this YouTube channel for free. And I bet you that watching my videos will 101% improve your skill sets significantly. Cool, guys. So if you're not watched my last 4 to 5 videos, I'm making this entire playlist on Tradomate.one for my new viewers. Guys, this is my own platform. This is my startup called Tradomate.one. I started up this company with Yashu and Satyam. It is a trade analysis platform, and eventually will have some functionalities of trade execution as well. I'm glad to tell you that this is VC backed now. We are building this platform for you guys, for all the traders out there who are looking to make some great trading strategies, who are interested to make some intelligent trading decisions. So this is the website, guys, Tradomate.one. The link is in the description section as well. You can sign up for free. Just click on get started for free and then sign up with your email address or directly through Google, and this is what you will see in front of you. So I've actually built multiple trading strategies, so that's why I can see these trading bots here on my dashboard. You will see nothing over here. You'll create your first trading bot. On the left hand side, docs, which is basically the documentation. We'll refer it to this particular documentation in this video as well. Discord channel, we are calling it as Tradomate Army. It's a Discord server of like-minded people who interact with each other and with Tradomate team. I highly recommend you guys to be a part of it. It's free of cost as well. Cool. So let's start building our trading strategy. Click on create new bot. It asks for Python bot creator. These are all the example trading strategies that you can refer while making your own trading philosophy. These are not recommendations, guys. Again, just sample trading strategies. There are many sample strategies over here. Today I'm making video on EMA plus Doji, which is this one. I'll select this, click on proceed. Perfect. In the last video, I selected ITC. In this video, let's go with, say, Infosys, infi.ns. So in the bottom, you'll see this entire code of EMA plus Doji. We'll come to this particular section in some time. Over here, you'll see this candlesticks chart of Infosys, and these are the intervals from 1 minute, 5 minutes, 15 minutes, and so on. For example, if we select 4 hours, it will make 4 hours candlesticks chart over here. Perfect. Infi.ns is the ticker, NSE is the exchange, Indian rupee is the currency, right? And this is 4 minutes, sorry, 4 hours candlesticks intervals, right? Cool. Now let's do one thing. I'll just expand this a bit. Let me just briefly tell you, briefly explain this particular code. We are starting with importing Tradomate as TM. This is the in-house library that we are using at this particular platform. You'll find all the functionalities in just one library itself. The first function is for defining all the inputs that we have. The second function is for making our own trading strategy. If you have watched my last videos, you already know this segment. So let's do one thing. I'll just run this particular trading strategy. Let's see what are the results. Perfect. So you can see that we have many long and short positions on the candlesticks chart. We have the EMA line over here, and I think this is the Doji that we are drawing here, all the places where there is a Doji candle, right? So let's just try to understand the code a bit more, right? As we can see that right now it's a loss-making trading strategy, but that's not a problem at all. We are calculating the EMA first. That's what we are plotting with color is equal to aqua. Is Doji, this is a Boolean that we are introducing to understand if the candle is Doji or not, which is basically, this is the logic for Doji, right? Basically what we are saying is if the percent difference between open and close is less than this particular number, which is 0.05%, then we consider it as Doji. I think that's fair. Entry positions, the first is Boolean, which is Doji, and the second is the normal EMA condition. Elif is Doji is another Boolean, and then normal EMA condition for the sell position, right? And then we are closing the positions. So the first thing that I would like to say is, because there are many positions that are being closed here, so I am actually not very much interested in closing the position. So I'll just comment this entire section, right? That's one thing. Secondly, here I will increase the quantity from 1 to say 10, or actually we can even do 20, because the current price is somewhere around 1500, actually not even 1500, it's around 1800. If we are trading 20, which is somewhere around 36,000 rupees, still less than 50,000, so we can definitely trade 20 stocks in just one position itself. EMA length, let's keep it like this only, and that's it. Let's save and run again. Perfect, we have made some profits, right? But the total number of trades is very low, right? Also, the CAGR is only 0.09%. The maximum drawdown is 28.33%, which is huge. So this is the first layer of backtesting, right? At Tradomate.one, we have three-layer backtesting approach, right? The first layer gives things like net profit, CAGR, maximum drawdown, as you can see. The second layer is on risk ratio analysis, right? And the third layer is on scenario analysis, which is market trends, right? You guys already know, if you have watched my last videos. So this is the equity curve. You can see it's pretty well volatile, and I think this is where we are losing the most amount of money, and that's where we're getting the maximum drawdown as well. Clearly I see a need of stop loss in this strategy. If we see the risk and ratio analysis, the Sharpe ratio is negative, right? Beta is pretty high, close to one only. Sorting ratio is also negative. Gross loss was 43.61%, right? Gross profit is only 29.78%. I clearly see a need of stop loss here. Still, I'll click on orders. Let's see what are the profits, individual profits and losses. You can see some good profit amount, 10.3%, a huge loss of 9.55%. Let's just scroll down a bit to understand. 14.88% loss, 10.55%, 9.74%. This is where actually we are losing the most amount of money. So I'll introduce a stop loss. So with the second layer of backtesting, I got an understanding that I should be having a stop loss here. Let's keep it static only as of now. So I'll just provide config.sl% is equal to say 2%. Now here I'll just provide SL stop loss percent is equal to, I'll just copy this and paste it here. Same goes with this one also, right? Let's save and run again. This is looking great. We have actually made some good progress here. We have a net profit of 25.64% now, with a CAGR of 8.88%. We are doing good now, but still not very good, because I think the CAGR should be at least more than 20%, then only it makes sense, right? That's one thing. Let's do one thing. In order to increase the number of trades, I can see only 28 trades. I want more trades, so let's just decrease this EMA length to say 7, and also increase the stop loss a bit. Let's run it again. Perfect, now we are actually talking. The net profit is 62.69%, CAGR is close to 20%. This strategy looks promising now. MDD is around 9%, not bad. Number of trades 52, again very good. Profit factor is 2.43%, this is good. So we are actually very close to what we need. But still, I would like to use the most favorite feature of Tradomate.one, which is, you guessed it right, this is the third layer of this particular backtesting. Clicking on scenario analysis will lead to this particular window. Let's select market trend and test the scenario. This takes some time because it does multiple iterations. But yeah, this will tell you if the strategy is only working in the bullish, bearish or sideways market. And actually it gives a very good understanding that which market trend is something that you should be working on. What I think because we are using EMA and Doji. Mostly it should be doing good in bullish time, decent in bearish time, and it should not be doing great in the sideways market. Let's see what are the results. Okay, we got it. So perfect, as we have already thought of, it's doing good in bullish time. It's doing better in bearish time. I was thinking that it will do better in bullish time, but yeah, it's the other way around. And it's not doing that good in sideways market, right? A CAGR, if you talk about the CAGR, which is compounded annual growth rate, CAGR is of sideways market is only 3.12%. It's still positive. I was thinking that it would be negative, but yeah, it's good. The bullish time and bearish time is decent, which is more than 10%. If you look at this particular graph, you'll see that this particular trend of bullish time is captured here. This trend of the bearish time is captured here. So yeah, actually it's doing pretty well in the bullish and bearish time. In the sideways market, the one thing is that it didn't take a lot of positions as well. Let's click on view all. So CAGR, we already checked. Maximum drawdown is almost similar in all of the trends. Profit factor is 1.74 in sideways market. That's good only. Number of trades, 20, only 20 trades in sideways market, 20 in bullish and 18 in bearish. So I think let's do one thing. Let's consider ADX in this particular trading strategy. Now ADX is a technical indicator which captures the trends, bullish or bearish. So, but not a very high number of ADX. Why? Because we are doing pretty good in the sideways market as well. It's positive. If it were negative, then I would have preferred a higher value of ADX in the strategy. So right now I'll be looking for somewhere around 10 to 15 as the benchmark for the ADX, and not 30, which is what most of the people do. That's one thing. Let's click on this candlesticks toggle and let's see what are all the positions that we are taking. Actually, I'm only interested in the sideways because we are anyways doing good in bullish and bearish trends. So yeah, this is the sideways. You can see a couple of stop losses that are being triggered in the sideways market. This short position is amazing, right? It made a great profit. Again, this one is also good, but this is not good because we took a long position here and then the stop loss was hit. Yeah, so this looks good as well. Not a lot of work needs to be done, to be honest. So I'll just introduce ADX only. And again, as I mentioned, not a very strict filter of ADX in the strategy. Somewhere around between 10 to 15 is something that I would be looking for. Cool. So let's expand this a bit again. Here I will introduce ADX. Let's do it here. So let's write ADX condition. So guys, actually I'm making the trading strategies as a trader only. You should be learning. If you are a new trader or just trying to explore trading, you should be learning how a trading strategy is created, right? We do multiple iterations and then eventually come to good looking numbers in the backtesting side. Now, backtesting doesn't guarantee any particular return. So we need to do some forward testing as well. We need to put this strategy on the paper trading as well. But yeah, it gives a very good idea of how this strategy might be working in future. So a backtesting of any trading strategy is something that we highly recommend. But always keep in mind that this is not the exact replica of future trades that we are doing here. So ADX calculations, let's just first calculate ADX. Again, we are just using TM, which is Tradomate library only here. We have ADX inside it. TA.TA, which is Tradomate.TechnicalAnalysis.ADX. And then inside this, source high, which is data dot high, source low, which is data dot low, source close, which is data dot close, and period, say 13. What else? I want to have an ADX condition. ADX condition is equal to ADX dot I log dot I log, and then -1, which is the last value of ADX, should be greater than or equal to, let's do 13 only. I'm not doing 30 or 25 or even for like 40, 45, because I don't want to lose out on the sideways market as well, because we are on a green territory, on the positive territory in the sideways market. I just want to put a very soft filter in this to make the, I would say, trades more towards a trendy market. But let's see, maybe like if we are not doing good in this particular segment, then we'll change the strategy accordingly. So I'll just provide it here and ADX, right? These are the buy and sell condition. In both the cases, I want to take position only if the ADX is greater than 13. Let's run the bot. Perfect. We are doing better than the last time. Not a significant difference, but yeah, we have more than 20% of the CAGR now. Because we are making very good returns here, I would like to increase the quantity a bit, say 28, and let's see what are the results. Because we are making more returns, then we have more money to take few, I would say, fresh trades. Oh, this is amazing. We have net profit of 94.34%, CAGR of close to 30% now. Maximum drawdown is in control, and profit factor is also amazing. So you can see how we improved the EMA and Doji strategy significantly using the three-layer backtesting approach at Tradomate.one. And actually, I would say that you can improve it further. So it's your homework. Please keep on working in this particular trading strategy. Make it more than 100%. You'll feel so great. So yes, guys, I'll leave it here. There can be more things that we can do in this particular trading strategy. But yeah, I think you got the idea. You know how to use this particular platform now. As I mentioned, we are building this platform for you guys only. If you have any feedbacks, on the right bottom, you'll see a speech bubble. Over there, you can just directly connect on WhatsApp with me to give any feedbacks that we should be considering in Tradomate.one platform. Or you can just directly write in the comment section as well. We will definitely do as good as possible to make this platform very useful for you guys. If you liked even one thing about this video, guys, hit on the like button, because it really helps with the YouTube algorithm. And also, this is how you'll be supporting my work. We are planning to upload many more videos on this YouTube channel. So click on subscribe button and also hit on the bell icon, because there are many more amazing videos that are about to come on this YouTube channel. In the next few videos, I will make more strategies using Tradomate.one platform. And I'm 100% sure that you would be amazed looking at some of the strategies results. So please stay tuned. And yes, I am repeating, don't forget to join the Discord community to stay in touch with the entire Tradomate team and other traders. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this video till the end. You can click here to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Over there, you'll see this entire playlist of Tradomate.one. And over there, you'll see this walkthrough video. Keep learning, keep financial programming. I'll see you very soon next Saturday with a new video. Until then, peace.